This episode is supported by Blue Apron. We all have habits we'd like to break, whether it's biting your fingernails, smoking, or eating late at night. But why are these habits so hard to break? Perhaps you think your day is made up of deliberate, conscious decisions, but in reality, a University of Duke study found that 45% of your everyday behaviors are actions that you repeat every day and tend to do in the same location. These are your habits. Habits are attributed to one of the most primitive structures in your brain, the basal ganglia, the same region that helps control processes such as breathing and swallowing. In an MIT experiment, a mouse sits behind a gate of a T-shaped maze where to the left is a piece of chocolate. When the door clicks, the mouse explores the maze, sniffing and scratching at the walls. First it explores to the right and then to the left, eventually finding the chocolate. A scan of their basal ganglia shows it's working furiously throughout the whole process. However, after a week of training, the mouse runs immediately towards the chocolate once the gate clicks. At this point, there's very little brain activity once the gate clicks, and the brain doesn't fire back up again until it reaches the chocolate. Our brains seek to minimize effort and space, and this kind of automatic brain behavior is referred to as chunking. Chunking aids in creating a new habit pattern in cells of the brain. It's like a task you do every day that you no longer really have to think about. Brushing your teeth or backing out of your driveway, skills that were once difficult to master but now become automatic. This process is a three-step loop. Step one is the cue, which for the mouse is the click of the gate. Step two is routine, run through the maze. And step three is the reward, in this case, chocolate. The cue and reward eventually intertwine, creating anticipation and cravings, another essential part of habits. Because we go into automatic mode during routines, our brains stop fully participating in decision making. Our habits will automatically unfold every time there is a cue. These habits can be so entrenched that the reward doesn't even have to be good. A study of habitual popcorn eaters at the movies found that they were minimally impacted by hunger or how much they liked the food, and they ate the same amount of popcorn regardless of whether it was stale or fresh. Our habits often overrule what we know is good for us. For example, a study of America's Take 5 campaign to encourage citizens to eat 5 fruits and vegetables a day found the program was effective in educating the public, but an assessment found that it did not change American intake, where only 11% met the goal. It changed people's intentions, but not their habits. So, what are you to do? Charles Duhigg, author of The Power of Habits, gives an example of buying a cookie every day around 3:15 p.m. at work. The cue is 3 o'clock, but the reward is a bit more complicated, as the cookie can be a bundle of many rewards. It could be a relief from hunger, or an energy boost, satiating a craving for something sweet, or it could be a nice break from work, or even an opportunity to talk to people. Duhigg wanted to break his cookie habit and, after some trial and error, discovered that what he really craved was socialization that came from buying the cookie. So around 3, he would get up and find someone to gossip with for 10 minutes instead. By using the same cue and the same reward of socialization, he was able to break the cookie habit. But what about habits that you don't always notice, like biting your nails? Psychologists suggest that first you think about when you bite your nails. Are you nervous or bored? In the case of boredom, nail biting offers a physical stimulation. So next, you need to mark down every time in your day you feel bored and have the compulsion to bite your nails. Maybe that's 5 times a day, maybe it's 28. But then you want to implement a competing response. Whenever you feel the desire to bite, you immediately put your hands in your pockets. Next, find a substitute that provides a quick physical stimulation, like rubbing your arm or tapping your knuckles on the desk. This allows for one habit to be replaced by another with a similar reward, but also uses the same cue. So, when you're ready to take on a bad habit, just remember, figure out what your body is actually craving, use the same cue and a reward that serves the correct purpose, and be patient to help build that new habit. Now, if your bad habit involves food, our sponsor for today's video, which is Blue Apron, has a perfect solution for you.
Right now, they're giving the first 100 people to sign up with our link, you can find it in the description, $40 off their first 2 weeks with their food service.
Not only is Blue Apron an awesome way to be more health conscious with your food, but it helps you to cook at home more, which is something that,
we've struggled with over our lives.
They actually deliver farm fresh ingredients right to your door in a little refrigerated pack in the exact portions you need. need for the recipes, which I think is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Not only are you going to be getting yummy and healthy meals, but it'll be helping you to learn how to cook because the recipes change every week and they're step by step and it's awesome to follow.
There are also different types of plans to choose from depending on how many people you're cooking for, whether it's like a family or a couple like us, just two people. And they have 8 meals per week and all the meals take under 40 minutes. Thank you so much to Blue Apron for sponsoring this video. Make sure you subscribe and we will see you next time for a new animated science video.
See you later.